again with another one. God placed something on my heart yesterday night, actually. And it actually, the revelation occurred to me at night, but the words I heard, the scripture I heard during the day yesterday. And what happened was I was sitting on my living room and I was listening to one of Fred Hammond's old songs. And one of the things he said is that that joy coming in the morning necessarily doesn't mean AM. And I was, he went on to say that it's when we decide to wake ourselves up into that joy. And we decide to wake up from that pain or that weeping that came from the night, that endured for the night. So I was just like, whoa, that's deep. So I'm going to get into this. I'm going to read you guys the scriptures. It is Psalm 30, verse 5. And it says, "For his anger is but for a moment. His favor is for life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning." So I'm going to get right into this. So basically, what hit me last night, I was like laying down, sleeping right there, and God just slapped me with it, and I'm just like, you know, so I was like literally really comfy. The AC is on, the fan's on, I got my covers on, I'm on my favorite pillow in the whole wide world, the bed is comfy, I'm about to knock out, and God's like, get up. And I was like, okay. So I had to share this with you guys. So weeping may endure for a night. Now, it said may, meaning we have the choice, meaning there's a decision that can be made. Meaning it is our decision to decide whether or not we want to continue in this weeping for this night. And remember what I said, that Fred Hammond said, that joy doesn't necessarily, oh, it was Israel Houghton. Never mind. My bad, guys. It was Israel Houghton. He was saying that it doesn't necessarily mean AM, meaning when you go to sleep and then when you wake up and the sun's out. Joy coming in the morning means when we decide to wake up and say, God, I'm going to let you have control. I'm not gonna let this situation get to me, because the Bible says, cast all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. It says, be not anxious, but in everything with prayer and things, through prayer with the and thanksgiving, let your requests be known to him. And I was just like, wow. So basically, like I said, morning doesn't necessarily mean AM. Morning is when we decide to wake up our souls and to embrace that joy that comes from Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for us, because he said that he will never give us more than we can bear. He never said we weren't gonna feel it, but he said he'll never give us more than we could bear, and that we don't have to continue feeling it all down and weeping. That doesn't come from God, that comes from the enemy. The enemy wants to hold you down throughout the night. God says, don't go to bed with stuff on your heart. So you know that in the scripture, yes, that's what David was feeling when he wrote this, but he understood, which is why he said, but, which contradicts the first statement saying, joy comes in the morning, meaning he decided to wake his soul up. He decided to say, I'm gonna wake up from this misery and give it to God. And that's what we sometimes neglect. We sometimes go to bed heavy-hearted. And God says, what are you doing? I'm right here, give it to me. And we're like, no, God, I want to be stuck in this misery. What we don't realize is that iniquity and the enemy is darkness. God says, what does light have any association with darkness? What does Christ have any association with Satan? Therefore, when you see nighttime, you don't see the sun out. You have to allow the sun's warmth and light to radiate in order to call it morning. Meaning that's when you fully surrender. You don't see it half moon, half sun. No, it's full morning or full night. It's one or the other. It is one or the other. So there, that's why that's why it says that, you know, weeping may endure for a night. Meaning we don't have to allow the enemy to keep getting us. Now, like I said, the enemy and iniquity and sin is all darkness, but God, Jesus Christ, is light. Therefore, joy comes when we decide to allow God into our life and our situations and let his warmth, his love, his mercy, his grace, his holiness, righteousness radiate throughout our lives, our body, our mind, and our soul. That joy that we can feel. When you have been delivered from something that has been getting to you, or something you've been suffering with, or something that you just did not know you had, and you realize, oh my gosh, it is taking a toll on me. When you get delivered from that, you feel that warmth. You then realize you've wakened your spirit up. This is basically talking about deliverance, being delivered. And he's saying right here, it is possible because joy comes in the morning. Meaning God is right there wanting and waiting for you to give it to him. Let us embrace this love that God has for us. Let us embrace his mercy, his love, and leave it to him, casting down everything that's in our lives that's trying to manipulate, destroy us, come against us. Let's lay that down, because it's going to make us go to bed feeling heavy. And God's saying, no, the joy is right here. But when you decide to wake up, then will you have it. When you decide to stop laying under the covers, feeling like your life is just worthless, feeling like your life just doesn't even matter anymore, feeling like you can't go on, God says, when you decide to realize that in your strength comes from me, because in Christ everything is possible, and we are strengthened by him. When we decide to do that, when we decide, okay, God, you said cast my cares upon you, I'm going to cast them right now, God. When God says, I've forgiven you and everything is gone, to be transformed and renewed in the mind, that's being delivered. That's when the joy comes. When will you decide to wake up and stop allowing the nighttime to fall on you? It's amazing how at night most people get all up in their emotions. And that's the time that God says, cast your cares on me. That's the time where God says, don't go to bed feeling like that. It's amazing how we allow that. And the enemy uses your emotions against you. It's amazing. How long are you going to let the enemy use you against you and God? Let's wake up, people. For those who are not saved and for those who are saved, this applies to everybody on this earth. Wake up and embrace his joy, because in the morning it will come. When you wake up, it is guaranteed. It is a promise that it will be there. There has to be a but after that weeping. There has to be a but. And that may is up to you. You can suppress it. You can demolish that in a second through prayer and through laying down and casting down everything on, that you have on you to God. Question is, are you going to? Are you ready to feel the joy? Are you ready to wake up? Get before God today if you haven't, and if you're suffering. I'm praying for every individual who watches this. I want to know if you guys are suffering, if you guys need any prayer requests. If you do, email me at dlovechannel@urbanleadersleague.com. You guys, please, I want to know if you need prayer. I want to know if you have been delivered, if this touched you. I want to know if God gave you revelation on this, so that we can praise God together. Because God says, when two come in touch, in agreement, there he will be. And I want to agree with you right now in the name of Jesus. Please. Stop weeping, because joy is right there waiting for you to wake up. Just that simple. God bless you guys, and I hope this touched you. Mwah.